I am pleased to say that the college is in a very strong condition as we enter into the academic year. And let me give you some indicators of what I would point to that would suggest that we're doing quite well. We have, in the undergraduate side, we've exceeded our admissions targets assigned by the university this year. We were one of only two colleges that did that this year, and we have been exceeding those targets now for several years running. We have an all-time high in our four-year and six-year graduation rates, and our retention rates are exceptionally high as well. The proportion of our students who are students of color, first-generation students, students who are Pell eligible, all of those are going up as well, both with our new students, our new high school students, and with our transfer students as well. So all of those are great signs. We have been doing an exceptionally good job and been very active hiring faculty over the past several years. Right now, in September of 2018, 22% of the faculty who are here were not here 5 years ago. So the college has really changed a lot over the last 5 years. We have a lot of new energy, a lot of new thinking, a lot of new methodologies and different kinds of questions being asked. So we are refreshing our ranks and we are really moving to new generations of scholars. We have, in addition to increasing our diversity among our students, we've increased diversity among our faculty and staff as well. I'll say something about that later. We have had a great deal of success with award winning among our students, our faculty, and our staff, including two Regents professors over the last 3 years. One, Chris Eugen from our sociology department, and then last year, Erica Lee from our history department. So we're doing very well being recognized at the very highest levels of the university. Throughout the college, I think we're doing a much better job communicating the work that we're doing and communicating the accomplishments of our alums, our faculty, our staff, and our students. A lot of the credit for that goes to an innovation in the college, which is referred to as CL Agency. It's a student-run, basically a student-run marketing and communications group that drives a lot of the content that gets our message out about the work going on in the departments. They create newsletters for the departments, and so on. We have, over the past 3 years, engaged in a collaborative planning process with our departments to really try to partner with our departments to identify what the key issues are and what some of the potential solutions might be. Overall, I've been quite satisfied with how that process has worked out in practice. We will be entering into our next sort of round two of three-year planning, so the first set of departments that came up for three-year plans a few years ago will be coming up again this year, and we'll be making a few tweaks to the process to really enhance the collaborative nature of it that much further. But overall, I think that's helped us develop more of a culture of innovation in our college and in our departments. We've encouraged risk-taking, we've encouraged pilot projects, seed projects, and so on. We have, across the college, established a strong set of interdisciplinary initiatives. What I particularly like about these is these create intellectual communities that people in the college obviously can partake in, people outside the college as well. But I think it's even maybe even more important for new scholars, new faculty members, new grad students to have a place to plug in, to have communities that are working on questions that they find of interest, and meeting people outside their disciplines as well. So whether we look at our RIGS initiative, which has been doing great work under the leadership of Karen Ho the past 2 years, our environmental humanities initiative, our interdisciplinary collaborative workshops, or any of the other initiatives that we've been doing that have been trying to pull people together across disciplines, the Consortium for the Study of the Premodern World, which was due to the very heavy efforts of J.B. Shank from the History Department. There are these communities now in place that weren't in place 5 years ago. On the somewhat more, maybe you might say, sort of nuts and bolts practical side of things, I am pleased to say that we ended our year with a balanced budget, which is not always the case for colleges both around our system and around the country. I can tell you we're in a good position there. One of the things that I've been committed to doing is providing more information about the college As you know, we have a website called CLARA, CLA Reporting and Analytics, clara.umn.edu. If you want any data on the college, I encourage you to go there and take a look. We will be adding more financial data to CLARA, so you'll get a further sense of the college's finances. We will also be starting to release an annual data pack, because we know not everybody wants to go into CLARA and do drop-down menus and all the other fun things that you can do if you get in there and get lost over a couple of hours. There's a lot you can do in there. But we do want to present a set of reports every year. So we'll be, within the next month or so, we will have a data pack of slides, mostly at the college level, some comparing with other colleges on campus, some are across time, some are a snapshot of the most recent year, just giving you a sense of where we are as a college. How are things changing? What's growing, and so on. And we'll update that every year in September or October. So that'll be coming soon, and I will email you, of course, when that is out. Another way to look at the accomplishments that we've had is through our roadmap report. We put one of these out every fall. The 2018 roadmap report is available at that address. All of you are here, as well as all of the department chairs, will be getting a hard copy of that in your campus mail sometime over the next couple of weeks. So there's a lot of good things going on. I want to take my time today to focus on three particular areas. First, I want to talk some about the shifting realities in higher education that we all work within. Secondly, I want to talk a bit about Roadmap Volume 2. And then last, I want to talk about our campaign progress, our fundraising campaign progress, and some of the outcomes that we've seen there.